I'm now calling the meeting into order. City of Las Vegas Youth Neighborhood Association Partnership Program. It's January 16, 2014, and the time is 3:40 p.m. Is this compliance with the open meeting law?
Yes, we are. And I will do the roll call right now. Chair Davis?
Here.
Chair Figueroa, Vice Chair Figueroa, excused. Member Reed?
Here.
Member Thaxton?
Here.
Member Lopez?
Here.
Member Reyes?
Here.
Member Zier?
Here.
Member DeWitt?
Here.
Member Rodriguez?
Here.
Member Shatler?
Here.
Member Skillbred?
Here.
Member Salazar? Excused. Member Millard? Excused. Member Reyes Jeronimo? Excused. Member Mitchell? Excused. Member Skousen?
Here.
And we have a quorum of 11.
Item number 3 on the agenda. Public comments during this portion of the agenda must be limited to matters on the agenda for action. If you wish to be heard, give your name for the record. The amount of discussion, as well as the amount of time any single speaker is allowed, may be limited. Okay, I see no one. Item number 4, for possible actions to approve the final minutes by reference of the regular meetings of January 17, 2014. May I have a motion?
So moved.
I second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passed. Item number 5. Report on Youth Neighborhood Association Partnership Program application submitted by Desert Pines High School, Two Little Leaders of Tomorrow Teen Council, East Las Vegas Youth Council, Hollingsworth Elementary School, Jalen's Gift Foundation, God's Angels and Company, Green Machine with Angel Wings, Las Vegas Academy, Maribelli Sweet Wonderful Awesome, Team SWAT, Northwest Youth Empowerment Council.
And excuse me, we need a motion to hold in abeyance the Gift Foundation, Jalen's Gift Foundation. No, I'm sorry. God's Angels? God's Angels and Company and Green Machine with Angel Wings.
So the ones that are checked off. Yeah. So we need to hold in abeyance. It's rescheduled for another meeting.
Yeah.
So moved.
23rd,
right?
To the 23rd, yes. And who made the motion?
I did this.
Okay.
Did
you? Second?
Yeah. I have a motion to obey God's Angels and Company, Green Machine with Angel Wings. To move them to the January 23rd meeting. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passed. May we have Desert Pines High School? My name is Kwasi Davis. I am the chair of the YNAB board. During the presentation, if you could Please speak clearly and loudly because the city clerk is recording. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation. Afterwards, we have 10 minutes to ask us any questions you may have. We can ask you any questions. Could you please state your name and what organization you're part of?
My name is Lily Caballero, and we are from the Math Club.
Okay. My name is Christian Flores, and I'm vice president of the Math Club.
My name is Edgar Cox, and I'm second vice president of the Math Club.
My name is Alexis Duggan, and I'm the secretary of the Math Club.
My name is Juan Hernandez, and I'm the Math Club treasurer.
My name is Kevin Perdomo, and I am the historian of this club.
Excuse me, can you say your name?
Okay. Can you guys please come closer and speak just a tad bit louder?
Yes.
Anytime you guys are ready.
Okay. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to be here today. We are from Desert Pines High School, and we are here representing the Math Club. I'm the president. Hello, my name is Lynn Caballero. Math Club is a place where students from Desert Pines High School can come in and be a part of the mathematical environment. When students come into the Math Club, they will be surrounded by their own peers and will feel comfortable to accept the help they need where they are weak in math.
Hello, I am Christian Flores, and helping our community, Math Club is a great way of helping all the students in our community. We as a group will help our fellow students who struggle with their homework, tests, and exams. With most important, students will succeed in their upcoming future.
The benefits of Math Club. Students will earn and maintain good grades. Students will be able to meet new people. Students will also be part of a safe and friendly environment. And students will be able to improve in communication and social skills. And they will also be able to improve in other classes.
Hi, now I'm going to explain why the Math Club is important. Math is one of the core subjects that students must pass not only in high school, but be able to use throughout their life for their career. In Math Club, students will get the help they need to pass math with a grade higher than average.
Some of the goals of Math Club. For Math Club to be succeed, we will need to encourage more students to come in and get help. Math Club members will need to advertise and make Math Club a more well-known after-school activity. And another Math Club goal is to see students improve and become a member of the Math Club family.
Okay. If we receive this grant, it will pay for some of these expenses. Okay. Our advisor, on a weekly basis, gets us cases of water, cups of noodles, boxes of chips, and he buys us granola bars. Throughout the week, he spends $37.41, and we have 20 weeks left in school, so we will approximately spend $750 more. The money that is left, we will use that money to buy sweaters for Math Club.
Structure of our Math Club. In the Math Club, there are 2 adult supervisors and 15 student tutors. During the tutoring sessions, the advisors coordinate the activities for the students. The tutoring sessions generally last 1 and 2 hours every Tuesdays and Thursdays. Every student tutor puts in their best efforts into helping our peers.
I want to share with you guys my experience before and after Math Club. These are my grades before I joined the Math Club, and you will see that they're not the best grades. I was not encouraged to go to class. I did not like going to classes, and I was not interested in school. After I joined Math Club, it really helped me out and stuff. Like, in the back page, you can see my new grades after only first quarter, and that's only a couple weeks of being in Math Club. And it didn't just help me with math, which was one of my biggest weaknesses, but it also helped me with other classes. Like, it made me become more confident about other classes. It made me want to go to class now. And then I joined Math Club because the environment was so friendly. The tutors and the advisors were really, really patient with me. And they just helped me become a better person.
Okay. Our club should definitely get funded because, one, it will help provide an environment for students to learn. 2, it will provide a safe and fun after-school activity to keep students out of trouble. And 3, it will help increase the graduation rate for a high-risk school like Desert Pines in Los Angeles. And as you guys may have heard, Desert Pines doesn't have the best reputation in Las Vegas. It's kind of one of those schools that people say, oh, you know, Desert Pines, like, ew. But, you know, Math Club is here to represent and to, you know, let everyone know that Desert Pines, you know, is better than people think. We strive for success. We want to have good futures, and we definitely want this. So, thank you guys so much for having us. You guys have any questions?
At this moment, we will be taking questions. Member Reyes.
Reyes.
Hi.
Hello.
Nice job.
Thank you.
How many, ideally, how many students would you like to be tutoring in the club?
Well, we tutor on Tuesdays and Thursdays after school. And usually, like, kids come in and they'll be like, oh, we need help with our homework, or can you help us out? Like, and we'll help them. But usually it's, like, about 10 students that come in to help. So, but we want more. Like, we want people to hear about it in our school. Because at other times, we don't really have, like, people don't know what's going on, so we want to let everyone know that Math Club is there to help.
So what are your plans for getting the word out?
Well, we have plans to put really big posters in everyone's classrooms. You know, Math Club, get help, get tutored. Yeah.
And have you done, like, a little study on in terms of how many kids are not doing as well in math? Is that something that's common at Desert Pines?
Well, yeah.
At Desert Pines right now.
Can you
say your name? Yes, my name is Bo. She's one of the advisors.
Can you spell it, please, sir?
B-O, Bo. Last name is S-H-I-H. We have a math proficiency rate of about 60%.
Okay.
Which, from what I understand, we're one of the lowest schools in the city, across the board. So when I got to the school, I'm actually a first-year teacher. I noticed there was half the teachers that taught math at that school left. So the last department chair was there, left. So the whole math department was kind of left, like, floating around, wasn't any help. And one of the goals we had this year was to see what we could do to get our students proficient in math. And what I find is a lot of the students, they want help, but as teachers, there's only, you know, I think 8 or 9 of us. So when you have 20 or 30 students coming for help, it doesn't work. Not only, you know, with nine teachers. So having the student tutors, it really does, you know, help the, you know, the masses. But about 60% proficiency. So, and I don't know if you guys know proficiency is what they need to graduate high school.
Also, like, I know math the problem because my first time in proficiency in math was 120.
Can you speak up, please?
Oh, this year, I mean, last year for proficiency when I took it, my rate was 120. And since I'm a junior, I retook it in the beginning of the year. And I was already in math club, and I went to 250. Which I didn't pass, but, I mean, it's a lot compared to 120 to 250. That's a big jump. So that's how I know math club was working.
Member Rodriguez?
I like the idea for the whole math club. I come from the school Western High School, which right now at the moment is one of the lowest high schools in the district. We have a math program, but what did you guys say you're going to waste the rest of the money on other than snacks?
Sweaters.
Wouldn't it be better to probably waste it on books or something?
Okay.
Okay.
Spend.
I can answer that question again now. Because we're in a high-need school, there's a lot of funding for books and equipment and pencils and things like that. But the sweaters, what's nice about that is kids are going to see the sweater around school, around the campus. And they might ask questions like, oh, yeah, there is a math club. And that's the whole point, is to get the awareness out there. We got a lot of the books, you know, but that doesn't excite kids. You know, they're not going to look at a book and be like, oh, you know, I'm excited. But, you know, seeing sweaters and, you know, I don't know what it is, but the sweaters really get the kids excited. And I don't know why, but you see all the clubs do it in school. You see all the sports teams, they do it, and it's just a way for the for the kids to get a little bit of pride in the club and excitement.
Yeah, because I mean, I don't think posters are really going to catch that many kids' attention as to a hoodie that someone's wearing would.
Yeah, especially at Desert Pine, you see a poster one day and then the next day it's like
gone.
On the floor, in the trash can.
Usually in the bathroom.
In the bathroom.
So the second page is the after, right?
Yes.
I'm sold. You did a great job. I mean, I wasn't very good at math either. I took a different approach. I had to ask a whole lot of questions and, you know, sometimes look dumb or anything. But, you know, the worst questions are those you don't ask. So, but no, wonderful turnaround. I mean, this
Thank
is
you.
A comment. Great job. I mean, you can do it. Anybody can do it, you know, so.
That's how I know, they're really patient with me. That's what I know about this club.
Oh, sure. So the high school, of course, has embraced the program, correct? Oh, yeah. And so you guys are all, you guys all see improvements, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's good. Well, keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Member Skousen?
How many people do you have, how many kids do you have in your math club, and how many kids are you, on average, do you serve?
There's about 15 tutors, and every week there's just new kids. We don't, there's like about 10 kids that come in to help, but there's always like the same kids that come in like every day after school, sometimes they stay overtime and, you know, get the help out there.
So are you hoping with this grant that you'll be able to boost your numbers as well, with the advertising and incentives?
Yes, definitely.
Member Daxton?
Which of you are tutors?
All of us.
So are you, even if you're having difficulties, are you considered a tutor?
Yeah, because some of the students that come in for help, it's not only one thing that they need help on. It's different things. So if one of us understands that the most, we're the ones that help them.
We all have our strong suits. Like maybe for me, geometry is better, and maybe for Lillian, algebra, we all help out with what we're strong in.
Or sometimes it's just easier to understand it from another teenager's point of view. Sometimes, like, he may explain something, I may not understand everything, and she could just fill it in and be like, oh, this is what he was trying to say.
And then sometimes when we, when, you know, some of us were like, oh, what is this about? Like, sometimes we get stumped too, you know, so that's when the advisors come in and, you know, it makes the student-teacher bond, you know, stronger.
And do the teachers come in too? Or just the, or is it just students?
No, teacher is there too.
Well, I just want to say thank it really for you to share your report card with us, you know, and show us your grades. That took a lot of courage, and I think that that was phenomenal that you were willing to share that with us. But you've done a great job, so keep up the good work.
Thank you.
The question also, a lot of the students that come in for help, one of the things I tell them, I say, hey, you might not be the best at it now, but through helping other kids, you're eventually going to get better. Our school is very, very low in terms of math proficiency. So, you know, we do have, I think we have one calculus class, which consists of like 5 students. And those are the ones that probably could tutor across all subjects. So I'm talking, you know, our tutors are not, you know, college-ready tutors. You know, I'm really just trying to get them to feel that math is something that they can enjoy. It's not something that you have to be, you know, already, you know, so far ahead for you to actually be good enough to help other people, you know. So a lot of them actually started just coming in for help, and I was saying, hey, look, you know, now that you understand what I'm tutoring you right now, why don't you pass that on to another kid? So that's kind of where we started, just passing that knowledge.
I think it's just like, we just try to make a better community. By someone helping someone else, we're both getting help. Like, the tutor might help me by becoming better at math. I become better by knowing the math. It's just a win-win.
And when tutors come in, you know, they get the help they need. And there's been a few students that after they get help, they're like, oh, you know, like, can we join math club? And we're just like, yes, you know, that's what we want. We want people, you know, be in math club, support math club. And so,
yeah, but to become a tutor, you have to have already achieved that level of success, right? So you've already done that, right?
Okay, obviously.
Just making sure. Just for the record.
Okay, all right. If you guys not received the full funded amount, do you think you'll still be able to do the project?
Yeah. Well, we can. We would always have, you know, other options. We could fundraise. We could, you know, do all kinds of stuff to, you know, get where we want to be. All
right. We will get where we want to be. This is just a boost for us, you know. But regardless if we win or not, we're still gonna keep trying our best, and we're still gonna be in this spirit, and we're still gonna keep doing what we're doing.
All right, well, thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you guys. We will be considering your application, and we will make our final recommendations on February 19th at the City Council.
Okay. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I would like to call the meeting back to order. I would like to I like the record to show that member Kimberly, member Geronimo, and member Salazar has joined the meeting. If we may please have Doolittle lead us up tomorrow to council. How you guys doing?
Good.
My name is Kwasi Davis. I'm the YNF chairboard. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation. And afterwards, we have 10 minutes for Q&A. If you guys could please state your names and what organization you're part of.
Oh, my name is Keanu Cooper, and I'm part of Doolittle Community Center Teen Council.
My name is Shetri Sasker, and I'm part of Doolittle Community
Can you speak up? Could you repeat it and speak up, please?
My name is Kiara Williams, and I'm from the
Gallery. She can't hear you.
You guys come forward so that you're closer to the microphone at the end of the table, please.
And you need to speak up.
And speak up.
Alright, my name is Kiara Williams, and I'm from the Doolittle Community Center.
My name is Bridgette Johnson, and I'm from the Doolittle Community Center.
My name is Shantae Webb, and I'm from the Doolittle Youth Community Center.
Okay, do your presentation if you could. Please speak clearly and loudly. And anytime you guys are ready.
Helping Me Find Fitness Day by Doolittle, Leaders of Tomorrow. For Doolittle, Leaders of Tomorrow, this is our first time applying for a grant. We are a new group with no returning participants from 2012 through 2013. Healthy Me Fitness Day will provide workshops that gives ideas on games to play to stay active, healthy snacks, choices, hygiene, and give information about community partners that help provide healthy lifestyles.
The community, the health plan, that it will help the community by promoting health and wellness while working to hinder those of obesity risks. The benefits of the Healthy Me Fitness Day will benefit the community by leading the kids in the right direction to exercise. The community will also gain a healthy experience by increasing their physical activities together. We are showing the community that we care about their health. We are showing them that fitness is good for the brain and the body.
We selected this project by listening to a guest speaker tell us about his problems with weight and as a child, a young adult, and how it became and how he overcame that by doing light exercises and eating healthy. We will be distributing flyers to the schools around Doolittle Community Center to tell kids about the upcoming Health Fitness Day. Our project is important because it gives us a chance to do something positive in the community that will hopefully stay with the youth. If the youth are not making healthy choices, this project will hopefully start them on their way to a healthy and happy lifestyle. We know that taking steps to improve health or maintain if it's already intact can make a positive difference in a person's life. We will contact local healthy lifestyle vendors to work the booths and give information for participants, leaders of tomorrow. We will provide snacks after the activities, leaders of tomorrow. We will provide informational booths for a healthy meat fitness participants by the community partners. We will provide examples of easy and healthy exercises, leaders of tomorrow, and the community partners. We will provide participant ribbons for the children, leaders of tomorrow.
Here's a list of our supplies, leggings and activities, and t-shirts, and healthy snacks / water. We are continuing to look for less expensive items that will help have our room in our budgets. The interaction between youth and adults will enforce on the project enforce the importance of the healthy lifestyle choices and the benefits that we can improve their quality of life. All information that will be provided or distributed, will be appropriate for the age and groups being served.
Contests include food cooking.
Could you speak up, please? Come closer.
For contests, you can hula hoop, play wall tennis, flying discos, which is frisbee, jump rope, and using inflatable dice. And there's races like the mammoth ball, beach ball, relay race, genuine potato sack, scooters, and catch. Each participant will receive a participation ribbon and certificate. Healthy snacks will be provided after the activities. The booths for participants will give information about healthy lifestyle choices. A healthy meat t-shirt will be given to the first 60 participants that signed up for the event.
Why you should plan our YNAP project, Ryan? Physical health is very important in the community today. We need the kids to be able to be active and happy with themselves and their bodies. We want them to be able to have fun and also be able to lose weight and keep everything together. Health choices are a healthy lifestyle that makes a better community and a better quality of life. And this is a win-win situation for everyone going around.
At this moment, we will be opening up for questions. Member Rodriguez?
I love the whole idea of actually making a community come out and participate in doing something. But did you guys say you guys were going to get donations from what exactly? Or did you mean trying?
We're trying to get donations from healthy vendors, with their food and PE teachers and people from gyms, trainers, sympathy, so it'll be able to express how important fitness is.
And for the equipment, have you tried contacting, I know Walmart has a bunch of that stuff, and they like to help out community groups, have you tried contacting them with other issues?
We actually haven't, but thank you so much for this question.
Member Johnny?
Who will be your guest speaker?
More of small activities and fun things for the kids.
saw on the slide there was a guest speaker or something like
that. We had a guest speaker who influenced us to make right choices and do healthy things for the kids. Sorry, but.
Member Reed?
Can you tell me the name of your advisor or who's helping you, your adult?
Ms. Lakeisha Higgins.
Okay.
And there's no more questions. Do you guys think you'll be able to still put the project through if you're not receiving the full funded amount?
We will try. Cut down some of the activities and the food choices and teachers.
If there's no one else. Thank you guys for coming. We appreciate it. We will be taking your application into consideration, and we will be making our final recommendations on February 19th at the City Council meeting. Thank you. Okay, now we'll be going into recess.
You don't know what you look like?
We all know what
you,
but you don't.
We're all looking at that. Okay, I remember that. Right? Okay, yeah, they were one of the groups that actually came.
Yes, we are. Okay, now I will be calling the meeting back to order.
Yeah.
Next up, we have East Las Vegas Youth Council. Quasi Davis. I am the YNAP chairman. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation. Afterwards, we'll have 10 minutes for Q&A. If you guys could please state your name and what organization you are a part of.
My name is Christina Contreras, and I'm part of the East Las Vegas Community Center, part of Youth Council.
I'm Zella
Carrillo,
and I'm part of the
Community
Center at East Las Vegas.
I'm Symphony Boomer, and I'm part of the East Las Vegas Community Center Youth Council.
My name is Talia Mandujano, and I'm part of East Las Vegas Community Center.
My name is Diego Ochoa, and I'm part of East Las Vegas Community Center.
My name is Adam Gutierrez, and I'm part of the East Las Vegas Community Center.
I'm Medica, I'm part of East Las Vegas Community Center.
Can you say your name one more time, please?
Edgar.
Edgar.
And his last name?
Yes. during the presentation, if you guys could speak up and clearly, because City Clerk is recording, and anytime you guys are ready.
Okay. Well, we're Batteries Included Youth Council at East Las Vegas. We were bored with the power to change the world. That's the graph from the last time that you gave us. Okay, we're Youth Council. We're a group of devoted teenagers. We're a group of teenagers that are shy, tall, just, and you name it, we got it. But that's not what we're part of Youth Council for, but part of Youth Council to make the change, and that's what unites us the most about teenagers. Past events that we've done an Easter egg hunt at other centers. We volunteered and hosted our very own haunted house, which you'll see in the next slide, a few pictures of. We've done back to school fairs. We've dealt with some situations. We've resolved those conflicts. For Christmas carnivals, we've delivered presents, and we worked alongside special ed kids. A neighborhood restoration. We've also cleaned parks up, and while we were cleaning those parks up, we got kids that were actually there to help us out to reach our full potential, to show that even they can like make a difference, something simple as cleaning up a park. And although, like, for me, it inspired me, like, I set up the cleanup in the park the day, and then the next day, a lot of youth came out, and it really inspired me. So, like, I'm young. I never knew we could like make that of an impact. I never knew like youth actually cared. That really affected me. And it's not just working too. I've seen the picture. We also have some fun doing it.
That's the Christmas carnival, the haunted house we held at the community center, and that's the park cleanup. And also at the center, whenever there's an event at the center, we always ask if they need help with anything. So if there's like, they need to set up, we're already on it. If they need help guiding people, telling people where to go, we're always the first ones there to help out. And in the mural, that's the first part of our project. We all gather Saturdays, November 10th, to go paint the mural, and we've been devoted to that ever since.
That was the first day that we did the mural. We were just painting the wall white at first.
You see that for you now?
We've been there every Saturday since for 4 hours every Saturday.
And none of us had ever had experience creating a mural or anything, so what we ended up with was really amazing.
And the first developed the idea for the mural was, we were just all together with the ideas, the diversity of our group, it brought out the potential of everyone.
We all had different ideas because everybody's their own individual. Everybody has their own way of thinking, and we all brought that to the table together, and we wanted to unify that. That's why our mural, the point of it is to unify and make known that there is diversity, but that's not a bad thing. There are absolutely no downfalls in this project, and that is one of the biggest, best things about this. That's one part of our mural. A bunch of walls, this is just one of them. At the end, we're going to write, united we stand, divided we fall, and that's very true for every occasion. And these are some of the children or teens in Youth Council that help out with the mural. As you can see, we started out with just a blank mural, painting it white, and we progressed to something bigger and better. And with the mural, the point of the mural, as I said earlier, is to unify and make known that there is diversity in the world. But that's, like I said earlier, that's not a bad thing either. Everybody has their own different things, and when we work together, people can reach their full potential. They can balance each other out. And working together, you can work on, it'll take time to work on things, but the point is that you'll get it done, and you'll get it done the right way. That way you can learn everybody's different ideas, and everybody's purpose, they learn themselves. And in Youth Council as well, we each develop our leadership skills. When we first arrived here, we first needed to organize who would do what, and we all just kind of went through theirs. After a few Saturdays working on it, as you can see, we've progressed well a lot. And the mural, we have, the progress and stuff for each with a partner, and with the partner, we painted it and stuff.
And every Saturday, no matter what situation was happening, we were always there. We were very persistent. Whether we had a ride there or not, we would find a way to get there every Saturday and work on the mural.
And our group, we're full of a lot of people with different backgrounds, and we all work together in this project. We all came together to get it done. Part of it, part one of it done. And the point of this project was it makes a good impact because of that diversity and all that.
We are currently done with two walls. And after this is only part one. So what we're asking for is the donation so we can finish up 40 something more walls of this.
And as she said earlier,
the funding, we need 20 gallons of paint, which would be $580, 40 white paint brushes, $110, 40 medium paint brushes, $80, 102-piece polyester rollers, $50, 10 paint roller pans, $25, 41-gallon sealers, $50, 4 cases of water, $16, snacks, $100, which comes up with a total of $995.
But you can't put a price on change.
There's one more part. Yeah.
space.
It's important for many reasons, like the mural, it like brings together our creativity and it improves on our leadership skills and it motivates the kids and it like helps us work on our communication skills and to resolve conflicts. We do a lot of stuff, we collaborate our ideas. Good for all of us. We work on our teamwork. Most importantly, we just work together.
And this is where discrimination comes in. We're, us teenagers, we're always categorized as people who cause issues, and like younger teens, the preteens, they have nowhere to go or nowhere. They have a bunch of energy, but have no place to out. Have no outlet. And we want to break. We don't want to be known for just being teenagers that stay at home, watch TV, and accomplish drama. No, that's not our hope for the future. That's what we're doing. We want people to look past like all those stereotypes and past stereotypes and
see us as individuals.
Yeah. Even from adults working together, we're all working together. Malagai, our artist, has been our mentor. Has support is there because we've never, ever had to do anything like this art. So what we came out with was really amazing, thanks to Malachi. Camille has always been there for us, taking us to the apartment complex where we painted this. Curtis,
he was always there to open up the bathroom for us.
And Joanne would bring us snacks out when we were out there painting, it was great to meet her. It taught us how to be safe.
Those are the reasons they were there. They were like keeping us safe, they were guiding us, and they were like keeping the groove, and they were keeping us focused the entire time, and it was a very positive environment for us.
Reflection. We're planning on when we're, because we're done with this part one of the mural, and we're planning on having a dedication to the neighborhood for the mural. We're gonna have like speeches like dedicating this mural towards them. And we're gonna have like a barbecue, we're gonna have the media out. Thank you. And then this is the finished part of part one of the mural. So we're planning on expanding on this. Diversity.
There was another part as to why us, and like, as Malachi said, the best way, why not?
She said earlier, we were devoted. There was one issue where we didn't have transportation, that was out of the situation, was out of our hands. So we actually busted there and we rode bikes there. We've been working on this for a couple months actually, and it's amazing, like, we don't have, like, we don't take anything out of this, like, we're always there, and we really want to expand on this, it just, yeah.
All right, now we'll be opening up to questions. Anybody has any questions? Member Skousen?
Have you thought about getting donations from either retailers in your area, or even the apartment complex that you're painting their wall?
Yeah, state your name.
I'm Malachi Williams. I'm the teen council supervisor for East Los Angeles. The apartment, I think it's a condo complex actually, they actually have donated the snacks for us while we're out there. So they have also donated paint. You know, so if we fall short on anything, they actually donate as much as they possibly can. Because this is a neighborhood restoration, so whatever they can donate, they do.
Member Schuyler?
So I heard you guys saying that you were going to paint like 40 plus walls. So what is that going to be in a like a wide region, or are they all going to be like in one area of the neighborhood, or how is that exactly going to work?
There's like all the walls are in a row. There's just one very long wall of walls. About 42, I think, in total. And so that will be them. It's just like they're all connected.
Okay.
Member Arias.
Hi, how are you? Now I forgot my question. Where's your event going to be held on the 25th? What's the location?
Of your
dedication, what's the actual?
It's on Lamont Stewart.
401 East Lamb. It's the Crossroads Apartment Complex.
Thank you. And how many youth are participating besides yourselves?
It's like 20 or more. Yeah,
about 20 to 30.
Is that 20 or 30 more excluding or excluding you guys here? Remember Daxton?
Have you guys thought about seeing if there's other youth councils that may want to assist you with this project to get it done faster?
Yes. Aside from the youth councils, we have seen if they want to stay incorporated, but also members of the community in the apartment complex there, like, when someone just recently was walking by and saw our wall and they asked when do they get to sign their name on it, and our president was thinking that we could have like a tree or something to incorporate them on their own wall with handprints or something for the members of the community and others.
Member Paxton?
Just a thought. If you guys have maybe all of the community, it seems that quite a few of the community centers through the city of Las Vegas have youth councils, and maybe you actually have a day where you invite the youth councils to come out and maybe assist, just a thought, but maybe you ask the other youth councils if they may want to participate and to help you get those 40 walls done, and maybe it's a big group effort, just a thought. And then, again, back to the donations, I don't know if you guys have a Home Depot in your area or a Lowe's, but I know that they do assist some, and Sherman Williams do assist with paint, so that might be another option that you guys may want to look at as well.
Member Reed?
If you guys don't receive your full grant that you requested, would you still be able to move forward with the project?
Yeah, of course we will. We'll find some way to keep moving forward. Nothing's going to stop it.
Okay. You guys did a good job.
Yes. Okay. Well, if there's no more questions, when you guys are through, could you please submit a copy of your PowerPoint to a staff member? We will be taking your application into consideration, and we will make our final recommendation on February 19th at the council meeting. You guys did a wonderful job. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. So now, I'll be calling the meeting to recess.
I can hear.
Wow. Okay, we're recording.
Okay, I will now be calling the meeting into order. Next up, we have Hollingsworth Elementary School. Hi guys!
Hi!
Are you guys excited?
Yes!
Okay, well.
Are we? We're very excited too.
My name is Quazze Davis. I'm the chairman of the board. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation, and afterwards you have 10 minutes to do Q&A, which is question and answer. During the presentation, if you could please speak clearly and loudly, because the city clerk is recording. So, anytime you guys are ready.
Hi,
Hi, we're from Humboldt Elementary School, and we're the student council.
Okay. Could you guys please introduce yourselves and tell us the organization you're a part of? Or the group you're a part of?
We're from Humboldt Elementary School, and we're the student council.
What's your name? My name is Leland Benton. I'm Aline Hyman. I'm Kismaya Rodriguez. I'm Mariana Gonzalez. And I'm Griffin. To help others. Our project is to purchase and fundraise socks and blankets for Sunrise Hospital patients. All patients like babies, kids, and adults will feel like they are being hugged when they receive socks. Teamwork is important. We work together to think about objects. We brainstorm with circle maps and talk as a group. We wanted to show other kids we are not too young to help others.
Our student council worked together with our community advisors and our peers to complete our project. We will purchase socks and blankets, and we will also let our school community donate too. When we pass out packages to patients, we plan to make them laugh and smile. If the doctor says it's okay, you could also try singing. We would like to set an example to other students in our school. They should know you are not too young or too small to help others. At the same time, the patients at the hospital will help will feel happy. And now we are thinking of them. It could even heal them.
We will take pictures of our project from start to finish. We will reflect on how we help our community by looking at these pictures. We will also make posters to hang in our school so students can see what our school did to help our community.
Thank you. On behalf of our school and our student council, we thank you. We hope you help us become great role models.
Okay. Well, does anybody have any questions? Marie?
So, do you plan on helping all the patients that you can at the hospital? Are you going to specifically go to the children's hospital? Or did you really have an idea on that of what patients you're looking for? If you're going to buy things like socks, are you buying kids' socks or adult socks?
They need help. They do something.
You can answer if you want.
Yeah, you can answer on their behalf.
So we will be helping the kids from like our age to like 14-year-olds.
Okay, that's great.
Member Shatlin?
So first of all, you guys all did a really good job. Just wanted to say that. And I just wanted to know, how did you come up with the idea? What made you guys want to help the kids out at the hospital?
Member Scalson?
How many bundles are you planning on doing? Were you hoping to do?
At least 1,000.
Okay.
I'm one of their advisors along with Ms. Benton and Ms. Eugene, who's not here.
Full name, please? Huh? Your full name?
My full name, Mari Needham, sir.
Yes. Could you spell it, please?
Oh, MARINEEDHAM. Needham. we were originally going to do Sunrise Hospital because it was close to us in distance, but since we needed to be at a city hospital, we're going to switch to UOC. So just so that you guys know.
So, if you guys did not get all of the money you guys requested, do you think you'll still be able to do the project somewhat? Yeah?
Let the children nod. Yeah,
let the children nod. Everybody well, thank you guys for coming. You guys did an amazing job.
Congratulations. Very impressive job.
We will be taking your application into consideration. Question?
I didn't have a question, but they were talking about it. This is all student generated, just to let you know. They did all the things that are on the PowerPoint. We allowed them, of course, we checked for spelling things like that. But they also thought of a sock hop too, where the kids could possibly together after at an after school event and donate that way. You did it fun.
That's very creative.
Well, that was fabulous.
Okay, we will be making our final recommendations on February 19th at the city council meeting here. So thank you guys for coming, and you guys did an amazing job. I will now be calling the meeting into recess.
I'll go get him, then I'll come in.
I'm going to be a kid man, you saw that. Back to order. Next, we have Jalen's Gift Foundation. Jalen's Gift Foundation. Hi.
Hello.
My name is Kwasi Davis. I am the YNF chairman. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation, and afterwards, 10 minutes for Q&A. If you could please state your name for in the organization with.
My name is Chanel Pineda. Ashley Brown. I'm one of the youth leaders of today's foundation.
Okay. During the presentation, if you could speak clearly and loudly, because the city clerk is recording. Anytime you guys are ready.
The name of the second person, I'm sorry.
The name.
Colleen Brown.
Anytime you guys ready?
An awesome baby brother, my parents at the hospital with the plastic bag with a few baby eyes. Another year,
Can you speak up just a little bit?
Another year,
closer so they can hear the mic.
Another family lost a baby and left the hospital with this memorial package. The difference is that was before Jan's gift, and this is after Jan's gift foundation.
On July 28th of 2007, my family and I lost my baby niece. At the time, we did receive a package similar to this one. And since then, we've been able to remember her by going through the box and remembering her few hours of life.
In this care package, it comes with a baby bear that represents the baby, a beanie that the baby can take pictures with, a blanket to comfort the moms, and a canvas for the foot and hand things. And a card from another grieving parent saying that they're sorry for your loss. This is a scrapbook. It has a certificate of life, the baby's footprints, the baby's handprints, and the mom or dad could write a note to the baby here. And this is just for pictures.
The meaning of this organization is to bring hope, support, and comfort for those who have lost their babies, parents, and families. This group is organized by Gabriella, and the ones who put the care package together are the families, the grieving parents, and a group, soul group from Green Valley.
At this moment, we will be answering questions, asking questions.
Yes.
Member Reed?
With this grant, how many care packages or boxes do you think you could?
With the grant, 50 care packages could be made. No, 100 care packages could be made. 50 will go to the UMC, and the other 50 will go to Mountain Vista.
And do you think that you can still move forward if we're unable to grant you the full amount?
Yes, we'll try our best to come up with fundraising money or do any kind of activities to make packages and take to the families that are in need.
Okay. Member Skilbrand?
Have you tried contacting, like, Joann's? I would think that they would help you with the ribbon and possibly even some of the boxes. That might be a good source.
Okay. There is no more. Okay, Member Shallon?
How did you two get involved with this organization?
Well, I asked my baby brother, and my mom was the one who she didn't want any other parent to feel the loneliness she felt when she left the hospital empty-handed.
I got involved when I came back from a trip over the summer. My sister told me to help her out and to support her through her loss. Even though it's been 5 years, I mean 7 years, she still goes through hard times.
Okay. Well, thank you guys for coming. I appreciate it. We will be considering your application, and our final recommendation will be going into the February 19th council meeting here. So thank you guys for coming.
Thank you for your time.
Now we can call me. Okay.
I'll let you know. Okay, then she sticks a finger up, points at us.
I will now be calling the meeting into order. We have Las Vegas Academy. Davis, I'm the wind-up chair board, chairman. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation, and afterwards we have 10 minutes for Q&A. If you could please state your name and what organization you're part of.
Okay, good evening. My name is Shadira Flores, and we're from the Las Vegas Academy site. I am the historian.
Hello, my name is TJ Brett from the LVA Las Vegas Academy site, and I am the treasurer.
Hello, my name is Courtney Jones. I'm from Las Vegas Academy Council, and I am the secretary.
Hi, my name is Sin Hayden Dingle. I am from Las Vegas Academy site, and I am the vice president.
And hello, I'm Kendra Patterson. I'm from Las Vegas Academy site, and I'm the president.
Okay, do the presentation if you could. Please speak clearly and loud because the city clerk is recording, and whenever you're ready.
Okay, to start off, we're going to put some music to get the little vibe going of our thing.
Is it Justin
Bieber? No, not quite. Okay, so our project is going to be held on April 12, 2014. And it will be hosted at the Doolittle Senior Center. This is a time for the senior citizens to have an event and just remember their adolescence. And it's time for them to create new memories with a new prom if they need to relive it.
This project is important to the community because it benefits the seniors a lot. Oftentimes, senior citizens don't really have a chance to get out and have fun. I mean, really, their families lock them away in a nursing home and visit them once a week, maybe. So this is an opportunity for them to do that. Also, an interesting fact is that depression rates among senior citizens are the highest in the country, contrary to popular belief. Depressive symptoms occur in 15% of senior citizens living in the community and 25% of those living in nursing homes. So hopefully with this event, we can assuage some of that sadness and just bring some happiness into their life.
As well, this will also benefit our youth. It'll give us a chance to get a job-like experience towards the whole thing, seeing the background behind the scenes of it all, putting it all together as a whole. It will also give us a chance to work and come get in cahoots with the adults.
Our inspiration for this project was we were thinking about our prom that's coming up soon in May, and we said, when we're seniors, are we gonna look back at our prom? And so we just thought of the idea, a senior prom.
This event is important because of the senior citizens, and we're just hoping to alleviate some of their depression symptoms and things that they're going to, and it'll also help them experience experiences with people from outside of their current environment. And it's also for the youth because we want to know how it is to run and plan an event.
Our committees include marketing. They make the invitations and advertisement. There's also costume and decorations. They will purchase the costumes and they will help put up decorations. Welcoming committee, which they are gonna greet guests, and they are also gonna make sure anyone that isn't supposed to be there, not to be there, and help with whatever is needed. There's also food service. There's going to be a buffet line, and they're going to serve those people, but they're also going to have servers that go to tables for those people who have mobile issues, and there will be set up and teardown to help set up before the event and clean up afterwards.
Youth and adult interaction comes in when the adults help supervise and plan and budget this event and make sure all the activities run smoothly.
Reflection. We'll be entering a competition, Class Act, and this competition basically will give our whole community service project recognition as well as our money, our school funding. will also be giving a presentation while announcing to our school about our prom, and will reflect back to the senior prom that we held.
Now for the requests. We have asked for $1,000 for the various items for like costumes, for setup and tear down decorations, and for the marketing committee. But we have gotten donations for food and for donations of money as well, and for the Doolittle is letting us use their community service.
Alright, so the reason that we feel that you should fund this is because it's really important to us. It's an opportunity for us to get community service in an untraditional way. Most teens think of community service, they're like, ew, I have to go pick up trash, or I have to spend 3 hours standing at a shelter. No. This time we get to do something fun. We get to plan a whole activity. And also, this is a huge opportunity for us to just interact, network. We've never done this before. We've never met these people before. Now we get to. Now we get to do something instead of just sitting around on Tumblr all day. Because once you do that, that's it. So really, we hope you'll just fund this and consider our project. Thank you.
Okay. Now we will answer questions. Does anybody have any questions? Memory?
Well, I don't really have a question, but I just want to tell you, you guys did an amazing job. You've been the most spirited and well-detailed group that we've seen. So I think you guys did a really, really fantastic job.
Thank you.
Member Scalson?
Where did you guys get your donations from?
Well, we got our donations from various groups. We mainly get it from the Batteries Included program, but also we have networked and gotten some donations from Porta Subs, and we're still looking for more donations throughout the city.
Remember Daxon? Anybody else up? Remember Reyes?
How are you going to outreach to the seniors and who are your target groups? How are you going to go about getting them in? And how many do you, how large is the target? How many people do you want to participate in the event?
Well, we're going to give them invitations and we're going to put flyers everywhere. But we're going to go to the Doolittle Community Center, meet with them, try and get their addresses, and formally invite them to the event. And we're thinking of like 60 to up.
Remember Daxton?
No, I was going to ask you about the costumes. Are the organizers and coordinators going to be in costume? And what are those costumes going to be?
Okay, so the theme of the prom is 1920s Prohibition era speakeasy.
Oh, okay.
And so we're going to, ladies will have flapper dresses that will be formal, not like revealing. We're not going to do that. And along with various accessories like peacock feather, because that's just very festive, and then men will be wearing nice suits along with fedoras, just to fit in with the theme.
That sounds great. Thank you.
Ms. Gilbert?
I noticed that when I was reading through, it mentioned that there would be movies playing. Do I have the right? Movies playing as opposed to music. Is that because you anticipate a large number of these 60 attendees are going to have mobility issues?
We plan to have live music as well. Like, we plan to audition people from our school because we have some talented musicians. But we also plan to just, like, hopefully we can get pictures of their prom from the first time and then put those on a PowerPoint and show those through the night so it can flash back.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Remember Rodriguez?
What kind of food are you going to be serving to them?
So we're mainly going to be serving, you know, normal prom food, like little finger sandwiches, maybe some pasta, some punch. Pretty much think your typical high school prom, really. There's going to be some desserts. So,
except elderly friendly, of course, because they have to have special food. Some of them have to have special food.
Yeah, so we're trying to accommodate for all of them, which means we're going to have to go to, we're going to the senior center and make sure that we have a list of, like, all allergies and make sure that we can accommodate those needs. So.
Okay. Well, thank you. The board will be considering your application, and we will make our final recommendations on February 19th at the council meeting. If you could please submit a copy of your PDF to the staff, and thank you guys for coming. I will now be calling the meeting into recess.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
I remember pulling that one too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ready, Z-Street.
Okay. I will now be calling the meeting back into order. Mirabelle, sweet, wonderful, assumed team, SWAT. Hi guys.
Hello. Hi.
My name is Quasi Davis. I am the wind-up chairman. If you can please state your name and what organization you're from.
Well, I'm Smolish. This is Justice, and that is Clarissa.
Could you say your full names, please?
Oh, I'm Smolish Gary.
I'm Clarissa Luna.
I'm Justice Rodriguez.
And we are part of the Mirabelle Community Center.
Okay. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation, and after that, you have 10 minutes for Q&A. During your presentation, if you can please speak clearly and loudly because the city clerk is recording, and anytime you guys are ready.
Well, it's no secret that the city of Las Vegas does pride itself in keeping its streets clean and its city well organized and a safe place for people to come and visit. So our proposal is to do something with animals, stray animals, and cats and dogs to keep them off the street so we can help clean up our city and make it a cleaner, safer place for people to come visit.
That's right. In correlation with what Smosh said, especially helping the dogs and cats in our Las Vegas Valley, we know that we can't give it to the city to make decisions that, so they make these decisions for them to, you know, sniff and neuter, and it's not fair, but, you know, it's a responsibility. It's, so we are taking part in participating and helping the cats and dogs so they can help the illness of hospitalized members at prisons and mental institutions. So, what?
What Claire was trying to say is we're working with an organization called Heaven Can Wait, which turns into taking in animals and spaying them so they can be put to use in prisons for mentally ill females who are alone and need companionship. So they put them in the prisons to make them so they don't act out or turn against whoever their supervisor is. So to help them keep in a calm state and to make sure that they're safe to be around. And we're going to be working with Heaven Can Wait so we can work to spay and neuter the animal, like 25 animals around the district, so we can start lowering the rate of stray animals on the streets because of overpopulation to the animals and the overpopulation on the streets. The animal population is becoming more and more looked upon because of all the euthanization and holding in pet shelters, animal shelters. So we're hoping to work with Heaven Can Wait to help better that problem in the city.
Basically, what Heaven Can Wait is going to do is they're going to take the animals and kind of just give the prisoners a friend and kind of just someone that can kind of comfort them.
basically just, you know, like, they don't have that.
So the way that we came up with the idea for this is that we did, each person in our center has a really unique favor for animals. One of our members actually volunteers at an animal shelter constantly, almost every week. She puts forth her time to make sure that animals are safe and healthy and are up for adoption, which not always happens. So we were hoping to have animals spayed and neutered so they could be put into shelters and not populate as much, because the average street cat will have at least 40 children at least a month during its mating cycle, and an average dog will have 30. So the overpopulation on the streets is rising, so we were hoping to kind of lower that, because we know we can't get to complete zero of overpopulation of animals on the streets, so we're hoping to lower it to where it's easy to manageable and euthanization has to be a last resort. And next, what we will be doing is for the youth and the adults to be working together in this. We will be volunteering our time with Heavington Wait, so we will be helping in the prepping process for the animals to go into surgery to have the spaying and neutering done to them. So, and then after that, we will be spending time with the animals that had the surgical process done to them, so they can help get better and hopefully get put to a nice person or family to help support with someone with a mental illness, so we can put forth our ideas and help them.
So basically, we're going to be learning the process of how to neuter, and also learning how they do it, so we can be in collaboration that in supporting. Sorry, I'm really nervous.
So, for this particular thing, we were asking for the grant for $1,000, the normal grant. And we also did set up a donation area in our center. We were asking for food, blankets, toys. So, if we do get any donations after the animals have gone through the process of the surgery, we can play with them and have a lot of fun and hopefully be able to give them a temporary home while they're healing. Mm-hmm. So.
Also, with $1,000, we're going to provide whoever the dog goes to with toys, beds, and all of that that we would have to play with them and kind of help them heal.
So. I believe that is what we have.
With the $1,000, we'll have only 20, we'll be able to neuter 25 dogs and cats.
Yeah, 25 dogs and cats will be neutered, spayed and neutered. So, because we know that we can't completely eradicate this problem, with any general problem. So we were hoping to start off at the beginning and slowly work our way towards our main goal, which is to lower the population.
Okay, great presentation. Does anybody have any questions? Member Brandon?
That was a fantastic presentation, by the way. I love the idea, totally in love with animals, so I'm very supportive of everything that you want to do. I was looking at your budget, though, on your application. You said that you were accepting up to $900 of donations of toys, foods, and blankets, but we're also spending $300 for the same items. So I was a little confused by that.
Well, we weren't so sure how many donations we would be receiving. So the reason, because we did set up stands at multiple stores for donations, like the beds and the blankets and the toys and the food. So. And if it did run short of what we were thinking of getting, we would use some of the money that we got to pay for supplies to give to the center.
Member Reed?
Okay, so this year we don't have enough money to give everybody their full grants. potentially. Would you be able to move forward with maybe spaying and neutering less dogs, or will you be able to move to go ahead and do the project without the full funding?
I believe we would, because typically we don't have to do the necessary amount of dogs that we are hoping to do, but typically our main goal is just to lower the population of stray animals on the streets. So any small effect that we could have on that would be great. So we would be willing to accept a lower amount.
Okay.
Member Skousen?
Thank you. I was curious about the budget too. So it looks like you're preparing to spay and neuter 25 dogs, have their teeth cleaned, microchipped, vaccinated, all those things for 25 dogs.
Well,
that's included in the price of the $1,000.
I think it's only for spay and neuter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. So you have things like having their teeth cleaned for $50, 25 dogs teeth cleaned. That's not part of it.
Well, we don't necessarily. We're not sure what the entire process will. What the entire process is. So if that did, if the teeth cleaning and all the other essentials did indeed happen, we would see how much money we have left to supply that towards the process. And if we didn't, we would try to manage the more important things like healthy teeth, healthy mouth, healthy body in a sense.
And where else are you putting your collection boxes besides the Mirabelli Center?
We're putting them in multiple stores. We're putting them in Walmart, Target, and Albertsons.
So they would see the box, and then they would go into the department store, and they would buy whatever, like cans of food and blankets, and they would drop it into the box. So it would be items that have never been used, and items from the store. So.
Have you guys thought about putting boxes in, like PetSmart and those pet-related ones?
Actually, I don't think we have, but that's actually But, because we mainly put our donation boxes in there because we know it's a general store, so we know that they have food. But it would be a good idea to put the boxes in pet stores.
It's a good idea because they're pet-related.
Remember Daxton?
I don't know that you'd be able to do it at the pet store, only because I know that actually the lead animal foundation's there every Saturday and Sunday, and they actually are collecting food for them. But something you may want to think about, Mirabelli is located in
Ward 1,
and Councilwoman Tarkanian is over that area and has a newsletter that they send out to their constituents. And I know that in Ward 6, when we actually put it in our newsletter, telling people that we had those donation boxes at our community center, we were overwhelmed with donations. So I'm sure that if you get in touch with Councilwoman Tarkanian's office, that they'd be willing to put that in their newsletter when you're ready to start accepting donations. Because we actually couldn't even get in our front door every day. Our office was filled with dog supplies, and when we stopped taking the dog supplies, people were upset because they still want to keep bringing us stuff. So people love their animals. So
that is a very good idea. I really appreciate that idea. We will talk about it, and hopefully we will be able to get a conversation with Mr. Tarkanian and talk it through, have it been put in the newsletter so we can get the word out. Thank you.
Member Brandy.
I had a question on your care packages as well that you stated. What has been consistent?
Well, the toys will definitely be consistent in the care packages, and the donations that we receive. We will have small things. We have like a small bag of kibble or dog food for the animals. We will have toys, some blankets to give to them so they can use.
The general message, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's what annual will consist in a care package.
Member Reed?
Okay, so following up on the pet supply pet store donations, the larger retailers like PetSmart and Petco, they do have kind of strict regulations, and a lot of them are already spoken for by other groups. But there's quite a few independent dog, cat, pet stores. I know there's at least two or three in Ward 1. But they're all over the valley, so you may want to consider asking some of those smaller sort of mom and pop pet stores if you can set something up there, because they probably are not as inundated with requests as the big stores.
I agree. We will definitely look into it because one of our members' moms went through a lot of trouble to help us. So she did talk to some of the stores along with us because we helped. And we will definitely look into that because it's a great idea. Thank you.
Questions? Okay. Well, we will be considering your application. We'll make our final recommendations on February 19th at the council meeting. You guys did a wonderful job. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you. Thank you.
I will now be calling the meeting into recess. I will now be calling the meeting back into order. We have Northwest Youth Empowerment Council. Hi guys, how's it going?
Good.
My name is Kwasi Davis. I'm the chairman for the YNF board. You guys will be given 10 minutes to make your presentation, and afterwards we'll have 10 minutes for Q&A. If you could please state your names and what organization you guys are a part of.
We are Councilor Nostin's Youth Empowerment Council. I'm Dara Westbay, the mayor pro tem and the youth league. I'm Moses Quiros.
Could you guys speak more, please, just a little bit? Yes, start over, please.
We're Councilman Ross's Youth Empowerment Council. I'm Dara Westbay, the mayor pro tem and the youth leader of this project.
I'm Moses Quiros. I'm the volunteer coordinator.
I'm Aviva Lesney.
I'm Hannah Jones.
I'm Angie Collins.
I'm Kara Zena.
I'm Rotasia Livingston.
I'm Tiara Richards.
I'm Danny Contreras.
Okay, during the presentation, if you could please speak clearly and loudly because the city clerk is recording, and anytime you guys are ready.
This is a quick video that's just going to kind of give you guys a more better understanding of who we want to help and why we want to help.
And we did YNAP last year,
and it got approved, and it was called Suitcases of Love, and we purchased 50 little duffel bags to fill with tons of hygiene items for homeless high school students who can't afford bags and stuff to carry.
Okay, so you may be wondering how we got the idea from Last Helpful Grad, and basically a representative from Project 150 came to one of our meetings and informed us a little bit about some things we may not know about some less fortunate students in our community. And he explained that while a lot of people's minds go straight to basic needs that they need, like toiletries and hygiene, we don't realize the little things that they don't get to participate in. And one of these things that really hit home for us is graduation. Some of you may not know that for graduation, you're required to wear a cap and gown if you want to walk, or you don't get to go to the ceremony and you get your diploma mailed to you. And just us imagining 4 years of hard work in high school and then not being able to go do something for money, it should really hit home, so we really felt passionate about doing this project.
We would like to share with you the involvement and effects of our project in the community. We are affiliated with 3 different organizations. One, the first being Title I Hope, which will help us distribute the caps and gowns to the students that will most need them and benefit them. We're also going to be working with Jostens, who will provide the caps and gowns at a discounted price. After January 1st, the caps and gowns go up to a price of $90, but we'll actually be getting them for $25 to $30, depending on the material and the color. We're also going to be working with the community, who will help, will try to be spreading the awareness through social media sites such as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and even broadcast in our school. We hope to not only affect the students that will be benefiting from our project, but also the community to spread the awareness of this issue.
On phase one, we will be contacting Title I Hope to provide the names to Johnston so the students can get the opportunity to go to Johnston and pick out their caps and gowns and have the skins that that every other high school student has. And other fundraisers that we will be doing to raise more money is a spring fling, which is something that we plan on doing and provide more money for our caps and gowns. We will set up a table and sell different things so we can gain more money. And Money in a Minute, we'll put our video up at school and see how much money we can change, we can collect in a minute to provide for more caps and gowns. Phase two, Title I Hope would help work with Johnston so students can get their caps and gowns.
The results of our project would we would raise about $7,100 worth in volunteer hours. You'll be able to get caps and gowns for at least 33 students with $1,000, and you'll provide 323 hours of community service combined.
We would like to thank you guys for the opportunity to come and talk and explain to you our project. Thank you for your time.
Okay, now we'll be going to the question section. Does anybody have any questions? Member?
Zier. So I just have to say thank you for that wonderful presentation. I work for Title I Hope, and so you guys were the providers for the last YNAP, and you know, those went to, you know, kids were ecstatic about them. They weren't little, they were actually really big bags, so that was wonderful. So I just wanted to give you guys kudos for that, and thank you for your efforts.
Member Kimberly?
I would just like to add on to her that it was a great presentation, and that maybe you guys could team up with other groups and help with the same project.
Member Reyes?
That was a wonderful presentation. I enjoyed that.
Good acting, by the way.
How many students are we looking at in terms of outreach, reaching out and helping? How many caps and gowns would you like to
with
be able to
$1,000, we can do at least 33.
33, with a discounted price.
Right. If you guys did not receive the full funded amount, do you think you'll still be able to do the project?
I think we'll be able to do it with our spring cleaning and the money for a minute to raise more money to add up to the $1,000 and get more caps and gowns.
Okay. Well, thank you guys for coming. The board will be considering your application. We will be putting our final recommendations in on February 19th at the council meeting. And thank you guys for coming. Item number 6 on the agenda. Citizens participation. Public comments during this portion of the agenda must be limited to matters within the jurisdiction of the board. No subject may be acted upon by the board unless that subject is on the agenda and is scheduled for action. If you wish to be heard, give your name for the record. The amount of discussions of any single subject as well as the amount of time any single speaker is allowed may be limited. If no one for citizen participation, no one. Okay. Meeting adjourned.